Welcome to a lesson on sampling methods. In this lesson, we'll define the different types of sampling methods when conducting a survey or poll. The first thing we should do before conducting a survey is to identify the population that we want to study. Once we identify the population, we need to select a survey method. However, a sampling method is biased if every member of the population doesn't have equal likelihood of being in the sample. The natural variation of samples is called sampling variability. This is unavoidable and expected in random sampling, and in most cases is not an issue. So we can't avoid sampling variability, but we should try to avoid sampling bias. The first method we'll discuss is a random sample, where a random sample is one in which each member of the population has an equal probability of being chosen. As an example, every member of the population has an ID, a computer generates random IDs, and the members with the random IDs are surveyed. This is an example of a random sample. Related to random sample is the simple random sample, also known as SRS. A simple random sample is one in which each sample of a particular size n is selected, such that every possible sample of size n has the same probability of being chosen. So notice for a random sample, we're selecting individual members of the population, but for a simple random sample, we're selecting a sample size of n. To help account for variability, pollsters may instead use what's called a stratified sample. In stratified sampling, a population is divided into a number of subgroups or strata. Random samples are then taken from each subgroup with sample sizes proportional to the size of the subgroup in the population. Stratified sampling can also be used to select a sample with people in desired age groups, political parties, sex, etc. So as an example of stratified sampling, consider the percent of employees in various age groups given here in this table. In a sample of 200 employees, they may randomly select 30 employees, 20 to 29 years of age, because 30 would be 15% of 200. 70 employees of age 30 to 39, because 70 is 35% of 200. 60 employees age 40 to 49, because 60 is 30% of 200. And finally, 40 employees of age 50 to 59, because 40 is 20% of 200. Quota sampling is a variation on stratified sampling, wherein samples are collected in each subgroup until the desired quota is met. So once again, as an example, consider the percent of employees in various age groups, as we saw on the previous slide, also provided here. In a sample of 200 employees, the pollsters would randomly select employees to poll. However, once 30 employees age 20 to 29 are polled, employees in this age group would no longer be polled. Again, we stop at 30 employees in this age group because 30 is 15% of 200, the sampling size. The same for the other groups until the quota for each age group is met. This method is easier than stratified sampling. This method is easier than stratified sampling, but does not ensure the same level of randomness. Another sampling method is cluster sampling, in which the population is divided into subgroups or clusters, and a set of subgroups are selected to be in the sample. As an example, if Taco Shack, a chain of 150 restaurants, wants to survey its customers about a possible new menu, management might randomly select 50 of the stores and conduct a survey. This would be cluster sampling. Another sampling method is called systematic sampling. In systematic sampling, every nth member of the population is selected to be in the sample. For example, to conduct a survey of students at a college, a pollster might contact every 50th name on a student enrollment list. Systematic sampling is not as random as simple random sampling. If your name is Victor Ruiz and your sister is Victoria Ruiz, more than likely you both would not end up in the sample because your names would be right next to each other. Remember, for a sample not to be biased, everyone should have the same chance of being selected. However, systematic sampling can yield acceptable samples. Perhaps the worst types of sampling methods are convenience samples and voluntary response samples. Convenience sampling is when samples are chosen by selecting whoever is convenient. As an example, a pollster may go to a mall and poll the first 50 people who agree to participate. This is convenience sampling. So while this method is usually quick and cheap, it often results in bias. Voluntary response sampling is allowing the sample to volunteer. For example, if you email out a poll or survey, those that respond are self-selected or volunteers to participate. This is voluntary response sampling. Usually voluntary response samples are skewed towards people who have a particularly strong opinion about the subject of the survey or have a lot of extra time on their hands. I hope you found this overview of the different sampling methods helpful. Thank you for watching.